Purge starts out with a really, really good idea for a movie. It's the near future, and the United States government has been overtaken by a vaguely defined and, in the first of multiple cowardly cop-outs, politically indiscernible faction called the New Founding Fathers, whose signature legislation is called, well, the Purge. For one 12-hour period, one day out of the year, everything is legal. You can do anything you want, steal anything you want, kill anyone you want, and not only will you not get arrested for it after, there will be zero police or emergency services around to stop you or protect your victims during the Purge itself. As the film opens, we're told that the Purge is considered a huge success, and that giving nearly everyone a yearly free pass to get their various rocks off has created a thriving economy and a stable, safe society otherwise. The possibilities inherent in this are damn near endless just based on how many questions the premise raises on its face. Yeah, stealing and killing may be the sexy cinematic crimes, but what else are people doing? Are hackers and black marketers doing all their work during the Purge? Do small-tier retail stores no longer exist because only big-box franchises can possibly afford the private armies necessary to keep their inventory safe? Would this not be the perfect moment for a foreign army or a terrorist cell to attack the United States? Is Vegas taking odds on everything? Are scientists getting together to conduct as much banned research as they can in the 12 hours, and yet, amid all these questions it opens up for exploration, the film only chooses to focus on one. What happens when an army of masked psychopaths attack your home? Something we've already seen explored many times in movies without all this elaborate setup. Yes, the film chooses to take one of the most fertile pitches I've heard in years and use it only as an excuse to make a slasher movie where they don't have to even bother coming up with a reason that no one calls the cops. Never mind that the real horror of this whole premise should be finding out just how evil, cruel, and awful all the ostensibly normal people you share the planet with turn out to be when you remove the possibility of them being punished. So just having the guys from The Strangers show up is a huge cowardly cop-out. Yes, a sliver of that scarier idea gets a moment in the sun, but honestly, if you don't call the supposedly shocking twist of the climax within the first 10 minutes of the movie, you need to start watching more movies. And on top of everything else, it opts to be an especially stupid slasher movie as well, and frustratingly, it's hard to tell if the problem is that the filmmakers are stupid themselves, or if they simply assumed that their audience was stupid, and which of those options is actually worse. But I'm getting ahead of myself. See, I lean toward the they assume the audience is stupid answer because the heavy presence of the class and economic ramifications of The Purge suggests that this was at one point a moderately intelligent screenplay. Logically, a murder freebie holiday would disproportionately affect poor citizens who can't afford significant protection, and the idea that maybe that's a real intended point of The Purge, i.e. facilitating mass elimination of non-contributing citizens, as a means of stabilizing the precious economy is a constant undercurrent through the film. To that end, our main character is an upscale suburban dad played by Ethan Hawke. He sells high-tech home security systems for a living, so not only is he personally not affected by the Purge, he's getting rich off of it. Unfortunately, once he's locked himself and his family safely inside their tacky McMansion fortress for the annual night of waiting out the Purge, his young son takes pity on a wounded homeless man he sees outside and disarms the system long enough for him to take shelter. Unfortunately, said homeless man was the designated prey for a party of masked, well-armed Purge participants who soon surround the house and demand the return of their plaything, or else they'll call in backup and take out everybody. Said villains, by the way, introduce themselves as being a gang of wealthy preppies who derive both pleasure and a sense of patriotic pride from slaughtering the poor. And this is where the Purge goes off the rails. Folks, explicit heavy-handed political message-mongering is not necessarily bad storytelling. Hell, my favorite movie is RoboCop, and RoboCop is about as subtle as a baseball bat to the face. As the saying goes, some anvils need to be dropped, class is a reliable source of solid drama, and the notion that sweeping showpiece anti-crime measures like The Purge do tend to disproportionately harm the lower classes while shielding or even benefiting the wealthy shouldn't be news to anyone at this point. But having your main villain basically walk up to the camera and say, "Hello, I'm a walking metaphor for the predatory nature of class disparity that inevitably results from unfettered capitalism and the consolidation of personal wealth," is just lazy, bad, stupid writing and filmmaking. The only way it could be less subtle is if the bad guy took off his mask and turned out to actually just be Mitt Romney. It's also too cowardly to get nasty about anything other than that particular low-hanging fruit. The homeless guy gets absolutely zero characterization, not even a name, outside of his function as a plot device, and a pair of military dog tags so that we know he must be a sympathetic good guy. And while the film does make sure to punish Hawke's character for being part of the problem, it still wants him to function as the obligatory father-knows-best home invasion fantasy figure to a large degree, including a well-shot but bizarre sequence where he Jackie Chans his way through a bunch of bad guys using the contents of his man cave. Somebody could have made either a really interesting or at least really twisted and fun movie out of The Purge. Instead, it's a dull, dreary, half-hearted slog of a film, prevented from being this week's worst movie solely by the virtue of The Internship opening the same day. See you next time!